Good morning and welcome to the lecture session on Bessel's equation, that is series solution of a Bessel's equation. And the Frobenius method, the working rule is like this. Consider a second order ODE in the form P0 of x y double dash plus P1 of x y dash plus P2 of x y is equals to 0. Let's call this as equation number 1, where P0, P1, P2 are all polynomials in the x. These are the values. That is P0, P1 and P2. With P0 of x is 0 and x is equals to 0. Now let us take y is equals to, this is the one, y is equal to summation AR x to the power of k plus r. And y dash, when we differentiate this, we get ar k plus r x to the power of k plus r minus 1. That is x to the power of k plus r, when we differentiate k plus r into x power k plus r minus 1, we get it. Next, coming to y double dash, that is the second derivative, we get it as ar into k plus r into k plus r minus 1 into x to the power of k plus r minus 2. Substituting all this in the first equation. And equate the coefficients of lowest degree term in the x to 0. This gives the quadratic equation in a k called indicial equation, say k1 and k2. In general, equate the coefficient of x to the power of k plus r to 0, which results a recurrence relation which helps to determine the constants a1, a2, a3, etc. in terms of a0. Equation 1 can be written as y is equal to x power k into a0 plus a1x plus a2 x square plus etc. Where y is a0 into x to the power of k into f of x, where f of x is an infinite series. Therefore, k1 minus k2 is not equal to 0, where 1 is 1, 2, etc. And general solution is y is equal to a y1 plus b y2, where a y1 is equals to a0 x power k1 f of x and y2 is a0 x power k2 into f of x. Series solution of Bessel differential equation. The Bessel differential equation of order n is given by x square y double dash plus x y dash plus x square minus n square into y is equals to 0. Call this as equation number 1, where n is a non-negative real constants. We employ the Frobenius method since the coefficient of y double dash is p0 of x. Here the p0 of x is equals to x square. When x is substituted as 0, it will become 0. That is, at x is equals to 0. Let us take y is equals to summation ar x to the power of k plus r and y dash is equals to ar k plus r x power k plus r minus 1. That is, on differentiation of this one, we get it. Again, this on differentiation, we get k plus r into the power, that is k plus r minus 1 into x power k plus r minus 2. That is what we get it on second derivative. So now the equation 1 implies ar k plus r minus 1 into x to the power of k plus r, and here it will be having x square, that on multiplication of this we will be getting only k plus r as a power, because this is x to the power of k plus r minus 2, but here x square will be there, so when multiplied it will be only x power k plus r. Similarly, here x to the power of k plus r minus 1 is there. When we multiply x to this, it will be getting only x to the power of k plus r. And whereas in this one, the third one, we have 1 minus, that is x ar x to the power of k plus r minus 2 minus n square times of this one. That is as it is. On solving, we get sigma x summation r is summation 0 to infinity ar x to the power of k plus r into k plus r whole square minus n square plus sigma AR into x to the power of k plus r plus 2 is equals to 0. Let's call this as equation number 2. Now, equate the coefficient of x power k such that, that is a naught into k squared minus n square is equal to 0. Since a naught is not equals to 0 and k squared minus n square is equals to 0, which implies that k is equals to plus or minus n. Here we can observe that only x to the power of k is only equated, because here r square term is there, it is k plus r whole square. When we do, what we will get it is k square plus r square plus 2kr. This is what we get it. This one multiplication with x to the power of k plus r, what we will be getting? X to the power of k plus r into k square and x to the power of k plus r into r square, and this is what we will be getting it. So that we have checked it, only x to the power of k alone we need to do it, and we get the result. Okay, so since a naught is not equals to 0 and k square minus n square is equals to 0, we get k is equals to plus or minus n. The coefficient of x to the power of k plus 1 will be a1 into k plus 1 the whole square, that is when r is equals to 1. Okay. When r is equals to 1, here we will be getting this result, that is a1 into this one, when 0 to infinity, when we are putting the first term, that is when r is equals to 1, this is what we will be getting. So this is equated to 0. And when this implies that a1 is equal to 0, or this is equals to 0. So which cannot be accepted, as we have k is equals to plus or minus n. Now coefficient of x to the power of k plus r, if we take AR, k plus r whole square minus n square plus AR minus 2 is equated to 0. So, out of this, we are taking this AR minus 2 to the right hand side, it will become minus sign. And this is taken to the denominator, we will get here k plus r whole square minus n square. So, what is AR here? This is what we will be getting, where r is greater or equals to 2. Let's call this as equation number 3. When k is plus n, in the previous slide I have shown k is equals to plus or minus n. So when k is plus n, what happens? Here we will be getting n plus r the whole square, and n square gets cancelled. We get it as 2nr, because k is n here, 2nr and plus r square, because n square is cancelled. So we get it as 2nr plus r square, and in the numerator ar minus 2. Put r is equals to 2, 3, 4, etc. Then we will be getting a2 is equals to a0 by 4n plus 2, 4. Or we can take the 4 outside, we get it as minus a0 by 4 times of n plus 1. And a3 will be 0. And here we can observe that when a1 is 0, a3, a5, a7, etc. all will be 0, because a1 is 0. That means all the odd suffixes of a will be 0. Only we will be getting a2, a4, a6, etc. and which in turn can be expressed in terms of a0. Here we can observe a2, we are getting it in terms of a0 readily available. And this is written like this. And later when we take the a4, then what happens? Minus of a2 divided by this one. Again, this a2 is replaced with minus a0 divided by 4 times of this one. So, already minus is there, here on minus. So, it will become plus a0. And 8 into 4, here it is 8 and here it is 4, it will become 32. N plus 1 it is here and n plus 2 it is here. Therefore, we are getting a naught divided by 32 into n plus 1 into n plus 2 and so on. Similarly, we can get for a6 also. Substituting all these values in the y, we get y is equals to x power k into a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus etc. And a1 is a naught x power n into 1 minus, here it is, 1 minus of x square by 2 square of this one plus x power 5, 4 divided by 2 power 5 into n plus 1 into n plus 2. Yes, x power 4 divided by 2 power 5 into n plus 1 into n plus 2 and etc. And similarly, y2 is going to be a naught into x power minus 1 minus n into 1 minus of x square by 2 square into minus n plus 1 x power 4 divided by 2 power 5 into etc. This is what we get it. So the general solution is given by y is equals to ay1 plus by2, where a and b are arbitrary constants. We shall standardize the solution by choosing a naught is equals to 1 divided by 2 power n into gamma of n plus 1. Here gamma of n plus 1, everyone knows the formula. So previously we can see this is what it is. So a naught can be written as this one, and y1 will be equal to x by 2 whole power n into 1 by gamma of n plus 1 minus x by 2 whole square into 1 by n plus 1 gamma n plus 1 plus x by 2 whole power 4 into 1 divided by n plus 1 n plus 2 gamma n plus 2 and so on. Use the property gamma n is equal to n minus 1 gamma n minus 1 gamma n minus 1, then we will obtain y1 is x by 2 whole power n minus 1 power 0 divided by gamma n plus 1 into 0 factorial x by 2 power 0 plus minus 1 power 1 divided by gamma n plus 2 into 1 factorial x by 2 whole square minus 1 square divided by gamma n plus 3 into 2 factorial x by 2 whole power 4 and so on. So x by 2 the whole power n summation r equals to 0 to infinity minus 1 power r by gamma of n plus r plus 1 r factorial. Here, since we have taken it as a summation, we are getting only x power 0 or x power 2. X power 2, x power 4 and so on, x by 2 whole power 4. So, we can, when you put the summation, r is 0 to infinity, we can write it as x by 2 to the power of 2r, where r is 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So, that we will be getting the powers respectively as 0, 2, 4 and so on. So we get y1 is equals to sigma minus 1 power r into x by 2 power n plus 2r divided into 1 upon gamma of n plus r plus 1 into r factorial. This is a standard one. The function y1 is called the Bessel function of the first kind of order n denoted by jn of x. Thus the jn of x is given by summation r is equals to 0 to infinity minus 1 power r into x by 2 power n plus 2r and 1 divided by gamma of n plus r plus 1 into r factorial. This is for the first case when we have taken n is k is equals to plus n. Let's see now for the second case, that is when k is equals to minus n. So this gives j minus n of x is equals to minus 1 power r x by 2 power minus n plus 2r into 1 divided by gamma of minus n plus r plus 1 into r factorial. Hence the general solution of the Bessel's equation is given by y is equals to a into jn of x plus b into j minus n of x. Thank you.